I have nothing left to bet, you idiot.
The plane.
That's rich. Oh, why the hell not? I've got you beaten anyway.
Yeah.
What have you got? Hmm? Wipe your mouth, Blackburn.
That wasn't supposed to happen.
But you know, I'll be taking that plane anyway.
What the bloody hell? You lost, I beat you! Mm.
The thing is, Rackham, it's a very beautiful aeroplane, and you're kind of a jackass.
I beat you fair and square, goddammit! Stay the hell away from my kind! Oh, you bastard! You can't do this to me, I beat you! I beat you!
My name's Clyde Blackburn. I'm a pilot and a gambler.
I'm George Rackham! I'm George bloody Rackham! Listen to me! You bastard, keep off my aeroplane!
If you asked me to name my biggest fault, I'd have to tell you. I'm just not a very honest person.
Welcome aboard! I'm Wilson, by the way. You must be George Rackham!
Sure, I'm Rackham. I'm your guy. Blood! Let's get this kite up in the air.
You're George Rackham, son of the 4th Earl of Windsor.
That's right. Hip, hip, baby.
The Bristol was everything it was advertised to be, a pure joy to fly. It was a crisp, sunny day, and everything would have been perfect had I only been alone.
You see those targets on the ground?
Yeah, I see them.
Try using the rockets on them. Get a feel for hitting the ground targets.
By the time we got the Jerry's beat.
I see.
You're a very suspicious man, Wilson. Has anyone ever told you that?
Jesus Christ! Germans! What do we do?
What do you think? We shoot them down!
Hold on! Rich is on our tail! Look! can from up front. More Jerrys! I see them! Hang on to your knickers!
That's how we accidentally discovered where Germans were keeping their munitions for half the Western Front. And Wilson's pictures would help HQ launch a major assault. There was just one problem.
I'm not sure about this.
Oh, come on! We did a great thing. We'll get medals for this.
We weren't even supposed to be there.
When the commander sees these pictures, he won't care. We did a great thing. We can do it again.
I'll make you a deal. If we pile up on this, then you need to promise me that you'll get me back in one piece.
Sure thing.
Promise. I need your word.
Okay, I promise.
Stay here. And don't cause any trouble.
You know, I did like the guy. But he was kind of naive.
Sir, you might want to take a look at these.
Saints alive, your man must be
one hell of a pile. Before we knew it, we were back in the air.
Taking position below!
I see them!
Let's put them out of action, quickly! We have to do something about those flak guns!
Yeah.
or this mission is bust!
I know!
Yeah.
tricky son of a bitch. Incoming fire!
Yeah, I noticed that, thanks.
The bird was busted. She buried her nose in no man's land a half mile due west of where I went down. Wilson, the poor sap, didn't make it out. But that was his bad luck. I had more pressing problems. Glad I still had a way with the old Barker. After plugging a few German stormtroopers, I was on my way west, heading back towards our side of the line.
near these sites are like.
Wir hätten einfach eine Mauer durch ganz Europa ziehen sollen. Dann hätten wir uns das alles hier gespart.
Those trenches were packed full of the Kaiser's finest, but hopefully, most of them would be looking for trouble coming. Hopefully. Dozen German machine guns at my back kinda encouraged me to keep my head down. No Man's Land was a maze of barbed wire, dead bodies, and debris. But I held my course. Did anything survive the crash that might be useful?
You're not George Rackham, are you? Son of the fourth bloody Earl of Windsor. How naive do you think I am? Oh.
Let's get out of here.
The guy was losing a lot of blood.
God almighty!
Jerry raiding party.
The Germans aren't really known for getting out. They did everything they could to catch us.
Wilson said I was a no-good, lying son of a bitch. I brought him home because I think he's probably right. And I hate that fact more than I can tell you.
Buried that man through no man's land? This guy's a bloody hero!
No, he's nothing of the sort. He's a cheat, a thief, and a liar. And he'll answer for his crimes. That's right, Blackburn.
To the farm, are you?
I'm gonna speak up for you, you know, at the court martial. It might do you some good.
I doubt
good.
It, but thanks.
Wilson, with me, I need a gunner.
Over here, I'll do it. Bracken, let me help.
You don't deserve to fly.
Wilson, if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die up there.
Come on, let's do this.
You sure you don't want to sit this one out?
Not a chance. You owe me a bloody medal.
All right, I got this.
Yeah.
The bombers are the threat. We have to take them down.
I'm gonna max the throttle and dive so the gunners can't hit us. Hold on!
6 o'clock, we have to shake him!
I'm
I'm gonna die up there. You and your big mouth.
You okay? I'm okay. We need to take out that flat gun. Okay, I've got your back.
All right, we gotta get up there.
Don't look down, all right?
All right.
Just don't bloody look down.
We gotta get the flat gun.
This is madness.
Balloon's gonna hear you.
My story. A selfish man who risked his own life to save another, and in doing so, found he was saved himself. Things get mixed up in wartime, though, and you'll probably hear other versions. A rogue pilot who stole a plane, who killed his buddy, then lied, cheated, and murdered his way across half the Western Front, only to escape court-martial in the chaos of an air raid. But don't listen to any of that. What you heard from me is the truth. I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. Would I?